Trubisky's middle four, one ball, making his way to the ring from Salisbury, North Carolina, weighing in at 214 pounds, Brad!
I've said it before and I'll say it again, this guy is an absolute fool.
He tried to jump over the rope, maybe he should have climbed up over the rope like he normally does. It's a nut job crash.
From Japan, weighing in at 206 pounds, Tajiri.
Yeah, this guy's all business, the Japanese buzzsaw. This will be a nice little cruiserweight matchup to start us off this week at Velocity, Mark.
Absolutely. And Michael, though, but everybody's talking about Survivor Series in 1 week at Madison Square Garden on pay-per-view in the huge match between The Big Show and Brock Lesnar for the WWE Championship.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head early on the show when you mentioned that Brock Lesnar must be furious this weekend. Furious and perhaps healing after being tossed, press slammed off that stage by The Big Show this past Thursday night on SmackDown. And I think the bottom line in all this is this, Mark, is the fact that Paul Heyman, the agent of Brock Lesnar, whether he wants to believe it or not, his prophecy is going to come true. I don't think that Brock Lesnar can beat The Big Show next Sunday night.
Really?
No, I don't think so. I mean, The Big Show's manhandled Brock Lesnar over the past couple of weeks. Threw him through an announce table, tossed him off the stage. Big Show's out of control.
Well, you know, kudos to Stephanie McMahon for bringing The Big Show to SmackDown. Nice takedown there by Tajiri. And you mentioned, look at Big Show's track record since coming here to Velocity. Wait, hang on, here's the try. Crash went for the quick cover. Now, here comes Tajiri. You said it, Michael. Quick action here with Crash and Tajiri. But look at The Big Show's track record since coming over to SmackDown. 3 weeks ago, throwing The Undertaker off the stage, damaging the ribs that we learned of The Undertaker. Then 2 weeks ago, the announce table putting Brock Lesnar through it. And then this past week, throwing Brock Lesnar, the champion,
off
the stage.
Crash Holly was going for the tarantula, and he paid for it. That's a Tajiri move.
What a shot there by Tajiri. Now, Crash holding the back of his head.
You know, talking about The Undertaker suffering rib injuries. Rumor has it The Undertaker is going to be back on SmackDown this coming Thursday night.
Look at Crash with his feet on the ropes and almost got Tajiri an illegal move there, but Tajiri is able to kick out. But the question is, Michael, though, with The Undertaker, the rumors are swirling that he might come back to SmackDown this upcoming week. But what kind of condition will The Undertaker be in? Not just physically, though, but mentally as well. Nice backbreaker there by Crash, and he goes for the cover, and Tajiri kicks out.
I'll tell you, I can't wait for SmackDown this coming week either in Columbus, Ohio, because I want to hear more about this new engagement between that goof Al Wilson and Dawn Marie.
Well, you know, I tried to get the scoop from Tori Wilson what her thoughts were, but it didn't happen.
You tried to get the scoop from her. She ran away from you crying.
Well, you know, I had to go and get, you know, the reaction, Tori Wilson, and she was obviously extremely upset. Another backbreaker there by Crash.
Well, wouldn't you be upset?
Yeah, Dawn Marie might be her stepmother.
Yeah. I mean, come on, think about it. Look at Crash Holly, the pressure now, and the back of Tajiri.
Crashing control, and here comes Tajiri trying to do anything to release that pressure, and was able to do that. Now Crash grabbing the side of his head, and here comes the Japanese buzzsaw with those quick feet.
Believe me, I'm sure Tajiri has been in that position a number of times with his old buddy Noble and Nydia. And speaking of Nydia, she's going on a blind date, that show blind date, this coming Tuesday.
Yeah, whoa. I guess, you know, Jamie Noble says, you know, good to go. Go for it,
From
Nydia.
What I understand, talking about it on SmackDown, I understand that Jamie Noble had something to do with getting Nydia set up for this blind date.
How about Tajiri setting up Crash just then? Crash thinking Tajiri's knocked out. Oh, there's a shot there by Tajiri. Now here's a hook of the outside leg, two, and Crash able to get the right shoulder up, but Crash was really fooled into that one.
Well, Tajiri's the master, the Japanese buzzsaw. Former cruiserweight champion.
Crash doesn't know what hit him right now. The momentum has definitely shifted in this match. Nice move there by Crash. Though here's the roll up. One, two.
Crash had the tights that time, but Tajiri still managed to kick out.
Here comes Crash again, and quick action here. The cruiserweight division, as everybody knows, only on the SmackDown side of things.
Wow, look at the bridge out by Tajiri. He's so quick with that bridge. Injured that already injured back.
And here comes to Jerry with a nice move there. What a roll up there to count it. Oh, there's a shot by those quick feet up to Jerry. Here's the hook of the outside leg again, two and three. No! Crash gets the left shoulder up to stay alive.
Tremendous cruiserweight matchup on Velocity.
Well, coming up later on, Michael, on Velocity, we're going to show you the great tag team championship match that happened this past week on SmackDown between Angle and Benoit, Rey Mysterio, and Edge. Great action.
Oh, two out of three falls matchup. One of the best matches of the year, in my estimation. We crown new tag team champions.
Incredible match. Shocking, too. Here comes the tarantula. Michael, like you always point out, it's an illegal move. Tajiri has to release Crash, but once again, could the damage be done to that really already damaged back of Crash? More damage, I should say. Two shots to the head, hook of the outside leg, and three, and that's it for Crash.
Here is your winner, Tajiri.
I'll tell you, there is nothing like the quick feet of the Japanese buzzsaw. Well, check out Tajiri.
Look at Crash's eyes just then. Doesn't know what hit him. And Tajiri wisely capitalizes on it again. Right. Boom. There's a shot. And I think that completely knocked Crash out.
Yeah, just with his goof Crash knees, to have his brain scrambled even more. Tajiri with a big win.
Here at Velocity, yeah. What does that say, Michael?
The Japanese buzzsaw. You don't read English?
You're out of here, Chad. Another one falls on Tough Enough, Michael. Big question is, who's next?
Hopefully you.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Boston, Mass. Weighing in at 350 pounds, Uber. And in the ring from Latrobe, Pennsylvania. Weighing in at 185 pounds, Jason Porcaro.
That's where Arnold Palmer's from, Latrobe, Pennsylvania.
Well, WWE Velocity is brought to you by Sony Pictures, Half Past Dead, in theaters November 15th.
And by Twix, it's all in the mix.
And by the new Castrol GTX High Mileage. Bad news for Jason, he has to go up against Albert.
Jason, is he the, his name, Porcaro? Isn't he the former drummer for Toto?
I don't know about that. Look at how cocky Albert is now. He's ready to give this guy, Jason, a free shot at his face.
Well, Jason's about my size. He's in there against the 350-pounder. That's good, Jason. Oh. The man wants you to punch him in the face,
geez.
And you grab a side headlock.
Exactly.
That's good for the career.
Albert, as always, means business. Wait, Albert could already have went for the cover, probably, and got the victory, but instead, Albert just wants to punish whoever's opponent is now. And he's doing just that there to Jason.
Well, you see referee Brian Hebner, and I've got to give huge props to Brian Hebner. He was the referee in the best two out of three falls matchup between Edge, Rey Mysterio, Kurt Angle, and Chris Benoit this past Thursday night on SmackDown. And I'll tell you what, Brian Hebner reversed a decision he had made earlier on in the matchup that made that match go on longer. You got to give Hebner big props for realizing he made a mistake.
I was just about to say, lots of times somebody won't reverse the call because they're afraid of making a mistake or admitting that they made a mistake. And Brian Hebner did just that. And Edge and Rey Mysterio, new WWE Tag Team Champions. And what a match, Michael. Two out of three falls, and you had a chance to sit ringside for it. Look at the bicycle kick there by Albert.
Well, Stephanie McMahon, the general manager of SmackDown, going to make a huge announcement this coming Tuesday. A UPN special Super Tuesday. Oh! 9, 8 Central. This coming Tuesday night, Stephanie going to tell us all about the tag team titles and what's going to happen to them at Survivor Series next week. Cannot wait for that.
Look at the strength by Albert. Oh, the Mondo Bomb. And this should be it for Porcaro. 2, 3, and that's it. Albert continues the role here in the WWE, destroying whoever is his opponent.
Oh, test the five.
Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Scott Steiner signed by the WWE. And I don't know about you, I got my fingers crossed that Scotty's coming to SmackDown.
Let's hope Scotty makes the right choice.
Contest is scheduled for one fall. Looking at the combined weight of 523 pounds, Devon and Ron Simmons.
And that's obviously coming to SmackDown. I mean, he has to look what Stephanie McMahon has done with the SmackDown superstars. Perfect example, the Big Show, and what it's really done for his career right now. Speaking of Survivor Series, Xbox presents WWE Survivor Series. This holiday season, there's no power greater than X. Check it out at Xbox.com. Of course, at Survivor Series, the Big Show goes one-on-one with Brock Lesnar for the WWE Championship. Madison Square Garden on pay-per-view.
From Japan, weighing in at 208 pounds, Funaki.
Here's the guy who gets all the scoops.
What?
Number one SmackDown announcer.
At least you don't see his interview subjects rushing from the building crying.
Hey, Tori Wilson was a little emotional. Wouldn't you be too if you know that your father's going to marry your rival?
Weighing in at 268 pounds, Chuck Palumbo.
If my father was going to marry Dawn Marie, I'd throw a party.
Yeah, because you're a guy.
Oh, that's great.
What?
You are the master of the obvious tonight.
Absolutely, as always. Should be some good tag team action here. Ron Simmons and D-Von, formidable duo, going up against really a new tag team here of Funaki and Chuck Palumbo.
Going to be an interesting tag team, and this crowd is into it.
Yeah, they are. And, you know, one of the things is how well can two superstars work together when they're teamed up? It obviously has worked for Rey Mysterio and Edge, capturing the WWE Tag Team Championship this past week on SmackDown.
Well, Edge is going to be part of a triple threat matchup this coming Tuesday night against Chris Benoit and Eddie Guerrero on WWE Super Tuesday.
Look at the power there by Chuck Palumbo, hooking the outside leg to it. Quickly, Ron Simmons gets the left shoulder up.
A special night Tuesday night, 9 o'clock, 8 central on UPN, Super Tuesday. Also a bikini challenge, interpromotional, between SmackDown's Tori Wilson, Raw's Trish Stratus, plus a huge 10-man tag team matchup from Raw. It's an interpromotion, Super Tuesday, Tuesday night.
9 o'clock, it will happen.
8 central.
And here comes Ron and Chuck locking up. Michael. Let's look at the huge matchup that will happen at Survivor Series between The Big Show and Brock Lesnar, and now the growing rift between Paul Heyman, Brock Lesnar's agent, and Brock Lesnar. And what's going on there, Mike?
Well, all I know is this. Paul Heyman proved a point in my mind this past Thursday night. Paul Heyman told Brock Lesnar, look out.
Hang on, here's a roll-up to it. Simmons gets out of it.
Paul Heyman was upset with the way that he believes Brock Lesnar's been treating him, that Brock Lesnar hasn't been listening to his advice. What does Paul Heyman do? Oh, look out. He tells Lesnar, good, go out to the ring tonight for the first time in your career by yourself. What happens? Lesnar gets press slammed off the stage by The Big Show. Paul Heyman has an argument to be made that he should have been out there to protect his client.
Look at Funaki there with the... What a shot there to the face of D-Von. All right, Michael, here's my question. Will Paul Heyman be ringside with Brock Lesnar come Survivor Series?
That's a great question. We won't know. Hopefully, we'll find out more. It's coming Thursday night on SmackDown from Ohio State University, Columbus, Ohio.
Look at D-Von in the strength. And I'm sure D-Von would like to get a shot at Chuck Palumbo. Of course, last week here at Velocity, Palumbo defeated D-Von, and there's a drop kick there by Funaki, and another one. Look at the quickness by Funaki. Here's a hook of the leg, and D-Von quickly gets out of it.
Well, Funaki keeps this up. D-Von won't get a shot at Palumbo.
Oh, what is Funaki doing? Do you think he is Ralph Macchio, the Karate Kid? And there's the tag, and here comes Ron Simmons.
Well, Ron ain't gonna sit around for that BS. And he said, come on and get your butt kicking. That's what he just told Funaki.
Yeah, Funaki, no match when it comes to strength with Ron Simmons. Yeah. You're right, Michael. Ron saying, go ahead, do it. See what happens to you.
Ron Simmons is all business. Ron Simmons just doesn't care. He goes out there just to beat the hell out of people because he enjoys it.
Yeah, and there's a good reason he could do it. It's because of the strength of Ron Simmons. Just incredible genetics, incredible strength. And there comes Funaki, another drop kick. Knocks Ron Simmons off his feet. Oh, wisely, Funaki doesn't go all the way up. Maybe not too wisely. Big clothesline there by Ron Simmons. Here's a hook to the outside leg to it. Funaki barely able to stay alive, and Funaki desperately needs to get to the corner to get a tag with Chuck.
Well, D-Von and Ron doing a great job isolating Funaki from his partner. Classic tag team wrestling.
You know, Michael, I can't wait to see what happens on Super Tuesday, the special we're talking about on UPN. What announcement Stephanie McMahon has to make about the WWE Tag Team Championship.
Well, Well, it's going to be interesting. It's going to take place in Survivor Series. Whatever happens with this announcement come this coming Tuesday.
Michael, do you think, speaking of Survivor Series, is Brock Lesnar right now, is he just not in the right frame of mind? How frustrated is Brock Lesnar over what's been going on with the Big Show? I mean, Brock Lesnar has never been in this situation before.
Well, Big Show is, of course, is frustrated. Brock Lesnar.
Jeez, look at the power there by D-Von. Two, and Funaki kicks out somehow.
But Lesnar just needs to be able to keep all that in check.
Look at D-Von taunting Chuck Palumbo just there.
Because Lesnar gets the Big Show at Survivor Series. He's just got to wait one more week.
How about the strategy by Ron Simmons and D-Von right now, Michael? You can tell they've been tagging for a little while now. The chemistry is there between these two superstars. Wisely keeping Funaki away from Chuck Palumbo so he can't make the tag.
Two, get out.
Funaki completely exhausted.
Well, of course, he needs to make a tag. D-Von and Ron Simmons doing a great job double-teaming Funaki as Funaki tries to fight back.
Nice retaliation there, though, by D-Von to keep Funaki off balance. And here comes another tag. Always keeping the fresher man in is D-Von and Ron Simmons.
Well, that's what you got to do. That's why these guys are tremendous tag team partners and tremendous tag team competitors.
Funaki is absolutely spent, completely exhausted.
Can he take advantage? Can Funaki take advantage?
Chuck Palumbo with his hand outstretched. Can Funaki get over there? Ron Simmons crawling back to his corner as well to try to make the tag with D-Von.
Chuck Palumbo wants in this matchup. Here he comes.
And here it comes. Here's the matchup I was talking about. Here comes Chuck Palumbo. Victorious last week against D-Von here on Velocity.
Let's go, baby!
Another back body drop. And Palumbo's on fire.
Yeah, he's all fired up.
Oh, look at the strength there by Chuck Palumbo. Here's a hook at outside, like two and three, no. D-Von gets the right shoulder up.
Palumbo is rolling. He's big, strong, and he's quick.
Oh, what a shot there.
The discus punch.
Palumbo with eyes in the back of his head, saw Ron Simmons coming and gives him a shot. And now Palumbo once again showing the strength that he has. Really taking on both Simmons and D-Von right now. There's the tag now to a fresh Funaki. Funaki climbing to the top rope. How about that? Wow. Cross body block. Two, three, no. Ron Simmons makes the save to keep the match alive.
Well, he's the veteran, Ron Simmons. Look at Funaki.
Oh. Shot there to the lower back.
Oh, look out.
Oh! Jeez. D-Von. Devastating move. Hook of the outside leg.
And oh!
I was ready to say three. It's over with.
Funaki somehow got the shoulder up. Tremendous fight in Funaki. And speaking of fight, Simmons and Chuck Palumbo going at it outside the ring.
Chaos ensuing here. Look at the roll up. Two, three.
Big win.
Oh, man. Just when I thought D-Von had the victory, Funaki pulls it out.
D-Von cannot believe that Funaki slipped by him in this tag team matchup.
Well, I don't think Ron Simmons can believe it either. He's looking at D-Von saying, what happened? We were in complete control of this match. But Funaki and Chuck Palumbo come out on top. Well, folks, don't miss Super Tuesday, UPN 9, 8 Central. A lot of great action will happen on the Super Tuesday special. Confidential is right now.